The Philippines reports 7,255 new cases Monday. That brings the country's overall caseload to 1,062,000. Active cases stand at over 69,000. 94 more patients died of COVID-19, pushing the death toll to 17,525. The health department, meanwhile, tags over 9,000 recoveries. These figures do not include data from 15 laboratories which were unable to submit the results on time.
Around 6,000 new contact tracers are expected to boost the country's fight against the pandemic. The new contact tracers will be deployed in the National Capital Region beginning this month. The Labor Department has allotted 280 million pesos for the project. It covers the three-month salary for the new contact tracers. That's around 537 pesos a day, or the daily minimum wage rate for workers in the NCR. The hiring of new contact tracers is a joint effort between three government agencies: the Labor Department, the Interior and Local Government Department, and the Metropolitan Manila Development Authority.
Hindi po masyadong mataas ang qualifications dahil ito po ay pasok lamang sa TUPAD program. Hindi po gaya nung dati nung ang DILG ay nag-hiring, ang hinahanap po natin doon ay mga college graduates. Para po dito ay high school din na rin po. Mas mababa po ang qualification for the DOLE contact tracing.
Some cities in Metro Manila receive Russia's Sputnik V vaccines today. These include the cities of Manila and Makati. They are among the five Metro Manila cities that will roll out the country's first 15,000 shots of Sputnik V vaccine. Each city will get 3,000 doses. The DOH has also identified the four hospitals and three vaccination facilities that have the appropriate cold storage facilities for those jabs. The vaccines need to be stored in temperatures below 18 degrees Celsius. The initial rollout will be used to prepare for the arrival of an additional 485,000 shots later this month.
Hindi po tayo pa nakakaroon ng experience na ganitong klase na requirement ng temperature. That's why we call it initial implementation, because we would like that we can see how we are going to manage it properly, to store it properly, and to distribute properly. So ngayon po, ito pong mapapauna natin na limang sites, titignan natin yung experience natin dyan. At kung meron tayong kailangang i-improve, i-improve po natin.
As the Philippines waits for the arrival of more COVID-19 vaccine doses, Valenzuela City launches interventions to address vaccine hesitancy. Mayor Rex Gachalian says efforts include automatic registration of all senior citizens in Valenzuela for the vaccination program. But he admits the turnout is still low.
We are still far off from getting 100% subscription, but we're getting there. At least meron kaming time to digest. So what are we doing, for instance? Just like in airlines, we're overbooking. So okay, if we were supposed to do, let's say, 50 senior citizen per hour, given that the turnout rate is at 45 to 55%, we're sending out more invitations, more appointments. So parang may overbooking scheme na kami in place right now. So it gives us time to recalibrate and to retool our rollout plan.
Over in San Juan City, Mayor Francis Zamora hopes more COVID-19 vaccines will arrive in his city. He says the city is logistically prepared for the vaccine rollout. But the problem is they don't have enough supply.
Yung supply ng vaccines na inaasahan namin, we have about 5,000 doses on hand now. Around 2,000 for first dose and around 3,000 for the second dose. But San Juan has procured 100,000 doses of AstraZeneca, expected to arrive sometime June or July. Once these vaccines arrive and indeed become part of our supply already, we can vaccinate 2,000 to 3,000 San Juaneños a day. Uh-huh. And at that rate, ilang weeks lang ay herd immunity ng San Juan.